Sammaniya Rajapal, Purva Nayadish Sri Sadaswamji, Sammaniya Mantri Dr. K.T. Jalil, Sammaniya Member of Parliament, Senior and Seasoned Political Leader, Long-Term Colleague of mine in Parliament, Sri Acharya K.V. Thomasji, Sri Hibi Hidden Member Legislative Assembly, Srimati Somini Jain, Honorable Mayor of Kochi Corporation, Sri T.J. Vinod, Deputy Mayor, Upamayor of Kochi, Yadavarakum, Yante Namaskaram. In Kochi Municipal Corporation Day, Suvarna Jubilee, Ago Shangal, Utkaranam, Cheyan, Enike Adiyaya, Santoshamunda. In Ivade Vula, Yella Pratilikulukum, Ende Ushmala, Asam Sakulum, Ajuadanalum, Nyan, Ariukyunu. Friends, I can't speak to you in your beautiful ancient language, the Malayali. I can only enjoy the language, but I can't express myself. There are similar words. I was just telling Mr. Jalil and also Sri Thomas Ji, the Santoshamu, Ahladamu, these are all common words and from our ancient language, Sanskrit also. But beyond that, I do not have the expertise and ability to speak in our beautiful language. I'm happy today that I have been invited to inaugurate the 50 years conference of this great historic city, Kochi. And I am thankful to the mayor, the deputy mayor, the corporators, the former mayors, former deputy mayors, standing committee chairmen, and also particularly the leader of the opposition in a corporation, that we all joined together on this historic day of celebrating corporations of Golden Jubilee. I'm very happy about the same, because Kochi is a very important commercial center of the country. After this, I am going to go and address the 160th year anniversary of the Kochi's Chamber of Commerce, one of the most ancient cities of our country, which used to have trade even outside India also. So that's why I feel extremely happy to inaugurate the Golden Jubilee celebrations of Kochi Municipal Corporation, which has carved a niche for itself in the area of local self-government. I convey my warm felicitations and greetings to all the delegates present here today, especially the leader of the corporation, the mayor, and the councillors of the Kochi Municipal Corporation. And I am particularly happy, irrespective of party affiliation, that everybody has turned up. After all, it's a celebration of not one mayor or deputy mayor. It's a celebration of the city and its corporation for successfully completing 50 meaningful years. I would also like to express my appreciation to all the stalwarts of the present, of the past, and also whose vision, efforts, and dedication enabled the local self-government to service its people for 50 long years. Friends, Golden Jubilee celebrations of any institution is not only an event of great importance and joy, but also an occasion to introspect, recollect the achievements and chalk out the action plan for the future. Today, when I stand before you to address this happy and solemn occasion, my thoughts go back not only to about 50 years, but beyond that. Kochi, the commercial hub of Kerala, is a city's steeped in history. It has been part of the urban history for hundreds of years and having had active trading and cultural relations with almost all major trading centers across the world. Kochi was in the world map even before some of the cities came into prominence. It has strong ties with the Greco-Romans, active trading relations with many South Asian and Southeast Asian nations, and also has been a colony of the Portuguese, the Dutch and the Britishers. Everybody in the world, the Tam, Dick and Harry, they came here, they colonized us, they ruled us, they ruined us, they looted us, they cheated us also. I may inform you, for your information, the India's GDP was 27% of the world GDP before the Britishers came here. 27% of the world, you can imagine. And that, the role of Cochin also was a major contribution because of the trade. In 1947, when India gained independence from British colonial rule, the Travancore was the first princely state to join the Indian Union willingly, Cochin and all. On the 9th July 1960, the Mattancherry Council of Kochi passed a resolution which was forwarded to the government requesting the formation of a municipal corporation by combining the then existing municipalities of Fort Kochi, Mattancherry and Ernakulam. Based on the report of the government-appointed commission, the Kerala Legislative Assembly approved the corporation formation on 1st November 1967, exactly 50 years ago, the Kochi Municipal Corporation came into existence. In the last 50 years, Kochi has grown to become a vibrant metropolis with a composite culture. It is one of the top destinations of the country for a wide range of industries and tourism, shipping, information technology to international trade and also biotechnology. Because nowadays, mere IT will not suffice. You have to combine IT and beauty. Then only you get beauty. Then only it will get beauty. Then you can make the country mighty if you combine these two. Biotechnology also is equally important now. It's a cosmopolitan city with a blend of rich culture, heritage, and modernization. Kochi is one of the most prosperous cities in the country and contributes a major chunk of its revenue to the state's coffers. The container transshipment terminal at Vallarpadam, international bunkering into an economic bunkering terminal, and the CNG terminal has developed Kochi into an economic and logistic hub. Kochi International Airport has set an example to others by becoming the first airport in the world to be completely operated on solar power. While Kochi Metro is effectively serving the commuting needs of a city population. I'm happy. I also have some association with the city in the sense that I was Minister of Urban Development, then this Kochi was declared as a smart city. One of the first five. It was during my period, I had the opportunity of taking part in the expansion of Kochi Metro Rail. It was during my period as a minister, the Kochi was declared as an Amrut city also. I feel happy. It's not any favor done by me. It's all because the Kochi city deserves all these facilities, then we have facilitated. Friends, I see in the coming years, Kochi to be one of the strongest and fastest cities in India. It is the first Indian tier 2 city to have a metro rail. It is a venue for one of the two submarines cable landings in India, and it is home to India's first global hub terminal. All these potential drivers act as the growth triggers for the city. Friends, the one of the ambitious missions of the Government of India, the Smart City Mission, seeks to develop cities into thriving, sustainable, resilient, inclusive and citizen-friendly urban centers. In the first round, out of the 20, Kochi is also there. How do you make a city into a smart city? You need a smart leader. not smart in the sense of height, weight, coat, boot, suit, hat. Smart in the sense of vision, smart in the sense of execution, implementation. And you not only need a smart leader, but a team of leaders, all the corporators. They should also become leaders. And all the people of the city, they should also take interest in their city. Then only the city can become a smart city. After all, what is smart city? Smart city is a livable city. Then you may ask, sir, are we not a livable city? Many of the cities in India are not livable. You have problems, including in capital, national capital. Because over the years, what happened, I want to be a little frank. I remember that I have a constitutional position as a Vice President of India, but at the same time, I have a weakness and strength of speaking from my heart. The local bodies, they play an important role. And we have a three-tier system in the country, the union government, the state government, and the local self-government. We call it as a local self-government. After 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment, we gave a lot of importance to local bodies. I'm happy I'm in Kerala, which has devolved more powers to local bodies. But many of the states in the country are yet to devolve all the 29 subjects which was there in the constitutional amendment. We need to devolve three things: funds, functions, and functionaries. Three F's should be devolved to the local bodies. Then only local bodies can be effective. And local bodies also must understand, they must follow transparency. Everything should be in black and white. Black and white means I am not against color. Simply being colorful alone will not suffice. You need to make the people to understand what is happening to Kochi, what is the project, how much is the cost, how it is being executed, what agency, what are the terms and conditions, and what is the time schedule. This should be known to the people. Then people will willing to pay taxes also. And secondly, there has to be accountability. Accountability of the engineer, of the bill collector, of the supervisor, of the town planning officer, of the commissioner, of the secretary, of the deputy mayor, of the mayor. There has to be an accountability. They must report back to the people what has been promised, what is being done, how it is being done. That's called as accountability. That should come into our system across the country. My advice is not for Kochi Municipal Corporation. This is for all bodies across the country. And I feel that there has to be a fixed tenure for the mayors. Otherwise, it will be difficult. Always, there are some states where the mayor tenure is 1 year or 2 years. And first year, felicitation. After year, after that, and worrying about carrying the majority. That should not be the case. If there is a tension in mind, there will not be attention towards the development. So we have to assure that there is a fixed tenure for the mayors and the elected bodies, municipal chairmen across the country. That's my strong feeling after so much experience in public life. And thirdly, Madam Mayor and also corporators, both parties, this party and that party, we must all see to it that we also raise revenues. We should not be looking to only to state. I have the experience of going around, and the practice has been mostly the municipality looks to the collector for extra fund. Collector will look to state minister, Mr. Jaleel, and Jaleel will look into chief minister. Chief minister will look into central government, finance minister, urban development minister looks to finance minister. Finance minister looks to prime minister, and the prime minister has to look to World Bank. There is nothing wrong in getting loan, in getting aid. At the end of it, people also should participate for their development. People will definitely participate in development provided if there is transparency, provided if there is accountability. This is the need of the hour across the country. Kochi is comparatively better. But I must tell you, across the country, the health of many municipalities is not up to the mark. Health and wealth. Health and wealth, they also go together. If you have health, then you can acquire wealth. If you have wealth only, no health, there is no guarantee that you will be able to enjoy the wealth. We should understand this. Health means, I'm not talking of the health of the health officers or this thing. Health includes swachhata, cleanliness, providing service to the people, getting their applications cleared in no time, and everything should become online. As an urban development minister, I called the meeting of civil aviation minister, then I called the meeting of national highway minister, then railway minister, then defense minister, then consumer affairs minister, then scores of other ministers. I convened a meeting to evolve to see that the applications of the people to get permission to construct a building in Kochi, why should people go to Delhi for permission from the airport of India? And then if there is some railway property near, go there. If there is some defense property here, and then you go to Delhi. What time you will come back, nobody knows. How much time it takes. So I conveyed a meeting and then briefed the Prime Minister the need for speedy approvals. And we were able to evolve a system. That's why, because of the efforts made recently, Mumbai and Delhi particularly, because the World Bank first takes into consideration those two cities. Ease of approvals. Earlier, I am told there used to be 49 agencies and it used to take months. Now the time has been considerably reduced. You apply, you get reply, otherwise it has been approved. That's the system. The same system should be followed, and everybody need not go to municipal corporation, meet and greet, shake hand and do something in between hands. That should not become necessary. You must file application online and you must get reply online, so that there is no need to be in line, means queue. This practice has to be implemented by all the urban local bodies. And we talk of ease of doing business, and if your application for a complex, for a house or for something is pending with the corporation for days together, or municipality for days together, then what is the meaning of development? So that's why I call upon all the local bodies across the country to see that every application is disposed of in a maximum time of 60 days. I'll be happy if it is done in 6 days, upper limit. Otherwise, it is approved. Second one is, I would appeal all the municipal local bodies also across the country taking this occasion to strengthen their internal resources also. Some people have the feeling, fear, sir, if I tax them, then they will axe me in the election. That's not the experience, I must tell you. If you take the people into confidence, if you are transparent, and if people know what are the benefits tomorrow you are going to get on account of this, people will be happily willing to pay taxes. And if you raise your tax revenue and you get matching grant from the government and then get support from outside, then you will be able to move forward. And then with the smart cities, a new model has come, PPP, private-public partnership. Earlier, private means was something anathema to us. Private means, when we are allowing FDI, when we are allowing China to enter and do business, we are allowing American companies, foreign companies, FDI, then what about the private participation? There are success stories of private. You have seen Kochi International Airport. You are seeing Delhi Airport. You are seeing Mumbai Airport. You are seeing Hyderabad and Bengaluru Airport. So this reservation should be removed from the mind. Public-private partnership should be there, but there has to be accountability. That's another important thing. Otherwise, I can tell you, friends, as Urban Development Minister, I received some 35, 40 ambassadors. Everybody was interested to invest in India. But they are saying, sir, we have to take so many permissions and then we have to go to this government, that government and all. That's why we created special purpose vehicle. That's why CEOs are appointed for the smart cities. And then people will be happily willing to come and invest so that they also get their returns. Nothing will be available free. For the poor people, it is our duty in the corporation to provide water. The poor people's water should not be charged at all. But the water consumed by restaurants, by hotels, by malls, by big people, there has to be metering and there has to be a charge correction. And then the properties, how much property is there? Who has constructed how much? You don't know. Mayor cannot know. It's only the building inspector or the surveyor there. He knows. Whatever he writes, that is the size. Now, new system has come because of the IT. Now you have GPS. And GPS system you can find without entering into the house, how much house you have constructed, how much building you have constructed. I'll just give you a small example of Hyderabad city. When they have gone for this GPS, earlier the revenue was 765 crores. And after that, without enhancing the tax, the revenue went up to 1035 crores. Bangalore experience also same. That is also new. So we must take advantage of the IT and combine it with our duty. Then you will get good revenue, and this evasion of tax can also be detected and more revenues to be collected. And everything should be in public domain. How much tax is being collected, all this, and how much is being spent on what subject should be given to media people. Let them write. Let there be debate. Let there be discussion. People should have the right to know what is the tax they are paying and what are the facilities they are getting. This should be a public matter of discussion, nothing to worry about discussion. Ah, of course, nowadays media, we have too many channels and they don't have that much work, so there is so much competition. How many channels, nobody knows. Earlier, there used to be only one channel, Doordarshan, Doorsay, Darshan Karna, Black and White Dekhna. Now you have 1,000 channels, TV 1 to TV 10, Aaj Tak, Kal Tak, Sidhi Baat, Ulti Baat, Kitna Baat Tha, Yaad Rakhna Mein Mushkil. You are making news, breaking news, good news, bad news, like the Khud Unika news, one channel against another channel. This competition will be there. But at the same time, we should not be afraid of transparency. It is our duty. If they go on false news, they lose their credibility. Because at the end of the day, I feel, I have my advice to media friends also, as I was minister for IADB for some time earlier, now also with this experience, information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. I repeat my words, information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. If you don't confirm the news and just inform for the sake of headline, please understand, it will become only a dead line the next moment when the truth comes out. So please keep that in mind. I appeal to all the local bodies from this beautiful city of Kochi that they should all focus on their internal resources, transparency, accountability, and the state governments also. I give a call to all the state governments, please see that the 29 subjects as enshrined in 73rd and 74th Amendment of the Constitution are devolved to the local bodies. It's a constitutional mandate. No state should withhold funds and keep it with the state government. They should be transferred and devolved to the local bodies. So friends, there is also increasing demand in services. People are demanding service. Expectations are gone high. They are raising. We must also live up to the expectations of the people. So, outdated laws and regulations which seeks to centralize powers and functions rather than decentralize them must be reworked. The top-down approach must be replaced by bottom-up of approach for finding effective governance at the local level. Times have changed and so have people's expectations. How Kochi should be a smart city? Plan should be finalized by Kochi, not by Delhi. It should be done in Delhi. What was Kochi yesterday? What is Kochi now? What will be Kochi tomorrow? You have to draw and then show to the people, this is how it is going to become a smart city. These are the facilities. Then people will have confidence. This is the way. Since mayors and corporators are all elected by the people, they would be directly answerable to the people voters. Therefore, greater accountability has to be infused in the functioning of the corporations, as I told you. Before I conclude, friends, I suggest the corporation to have more interface with the people and its officials. I have the experience of Indore Municipal Corporation, where I had a review and they made a presentation to me, where the Indore municipal population is 26,50,000. And with regard to the smart city exercise, 6 lakh people have participated in online or offline, giving their suggestions. That means almost 1/4 of the population. Then they will participate. So similar exercise must be taken by all the local bodies in shaping the destiny of the future of their cities. You have in Kerala, you have been successful to a great extent in carrying forward the spirit of decentralization. It is definitely highly commendable that you have been very responsive institution to local needs. I also would like to compliment and congratulate the Kochi Municipal Corporation for transforming itself into a people-friendly institution with a high degree of transparency and efficiency. Friends, this is a happy occasion. As I said in the beginning, it's time to introspect. Ek bar harek vyakti, harek adhikari, harek corporator, atma vimarsha karna chahiye. Humne kahan tak aage gaya, duniya bhar mein anubhav kya hai, what are the experiences across the globe, what are the best practices, and we must try to learn from their practices and then try to improve upon the services, the delivery. That is what is more important. I hope you will relentlessly work to be an institution of excellence, always alive to the current realities, agile enough to respond to changing context and forward-looking enough to anticipate future trends. I say the best municipal commissioner or the officer or mayor is the one who is on the streets by 5:30 in the morning. Before the city wakes up, these people should do one round in their respective areas so that things will take care of themselves. And that will bring in more and more accountability. I wish you all the very best in your endeavors to deliver high quality services to the city and its people. Thank you, and Namdi Jai Hind.